this is the subnet mask 255.255.255.0. This is the subnet mask. And then I type the commands no shutdown. This will ensure that this interface is up. Okay, this is turned up. Next, because we have IP phones, we cannot assign IP address directly into it. So we have to assign to other config, that is DHCP configuration, dynamic host configuration protocol. So I just enable this. So just first have to come out from it, exit, then IP DHCP. So I have to create a pool. I'll just name it, I can name anyone. I'll just, my name is Smile. Okay. Then I have to select the network for this, particular pool. So it is the 192.168.1.0. This is the pool. This is the network address. Then the subnet mask. .0. Okay. Now in our case, the default router is what we have assigned, 192.168.1.1. This is our default router. Then we have to enable the options also. Option 150, then IP 192.168.1.1. This command. We exit from this. Next, we have to enable the telephone service. So this is the command. Okay. Then max DN is 5. Then max ephone is also 5. Okay. Then what is our IP source? IP source address is of course 192.168.1.1, which our default router is, and the port is 2001. Next, we enable the command. We just use the command auto assign 4 to 6. And auto assign 1 to 5. Okay. Then we come out, we exit from this. Okay. And now, next, what we do is we come to the switch. Okay, switch part. I'll just take this switch down because when I okay, a little bit. So switch and CLI mode. Okay. Enable. Then config terminal. Okay. Now again we have to go to the interface of the switch. Now there are 24 interfaces. So out of which we will select the first 5 interface. Interface range, okay. Fast Ethernet 0/1 to 1-, that is 5. Okay. So here we type the command switch port. We have to use it for voice, and VLAN. We name the VLAN as number 1. Now this is done for the switch. We exit from here. Then come, we come again to the router part. This is the router. Okay. Now we have to assign some number to this two phones. These are the two IP phones. We have to assign the number to them, some dialing number. So for that purpose, we write the command ephone. DN 1. Then we assign the number as suppose 1111. 5 ones. I assign the number 5 ones to this, the first one. Okay. Sorry, I have to write number, not 1 1, but I've made a mistake. So number 1111. Okay. Then exit from this. Now we go to the second one. So E phone. DN 2. this is up. Now to assign the number, I will assign the number 2222. Okay, this is done. Okay, so I can exit from here. Now in this particular configuration, we have typed the command. Now we'll make the connection now. Okay, we'll do the connection now. So I'll just connect this particular router, fast Ethernet, to this particular. You can see that there are many interfaces. Okay, so I'll connect fast Ethernet 01. Okay, this may not be visible to you, but you can see fast Ethernet 0. I've just connected this fast Ethernet 01, and it is up. Then I connect this fast Ethernet 02. To this, there are two interfaces, switch and PC. I connect to switch because it is switch. Then here also, from here, fast Ethernet 03 to the switch. Now these two phones are off. We have to turn them on. So I click here, okay, and in the GU, okay, here only, you can see this is the cable. We just take the power cable and attach it here. Okay, it gets attached. You can see this gets attached. So this is turned on now. You can see this turned on. I'll click here. Okay, drag this power cable here and put it here. Okay, this is okay. So this is also on now. Okay. Now when we put the cursor here, you can see this arrow here. It is not still not assigned. It will take some time. So here we will see the VLAN, nothing is visible. VLAN address is also not assigned, and line number is also not assigned. And here also you can see it is not assigned. So it will take some time, and as soon as it gets the VLAN address and the dialing number, we will see how we can dial the phone. Okay, how we can dial the number. Now we can see it here. As soon as I put here, you can see the VLAN address is there, and the line number is 22222. And when I bring it here, you can see VLAN is assigned 192.168.1.2, and the line number is 11111. Okay. Let us see how to dial the number. I'll just put it. So I click here, and you can see this particular GUI on GUI mode, and yes. So this number, you can see this 22222, and I'll just bring in the second IP phone. So here we can see 1111. Let me keep both here. Now let us see if we are dialing from this to this. Okay, so IP phone 1, the number is 11111. So I will just dial 11111 and click here on the receiver. Now you can see it is blinking. The phone is connected. Okay, if I click here, it gets connected. You can see it is connected and connected. Now to disconnect the phone, I click it here and click here. Now you can dial from this phone to this phone. The number of this is 2222552, and dial it. You can see it is dialing. Okay, the phone is ringing. And this is how we perform this practical. So that's all for this particular session. Thanks for watching.